Hey, welcome to another episode of Cherish TV. Today, we are talking about spanking. To spank or not to spank. Is spanking effective discipline or is it abuse? Michaela Ray, I'm going to start with you.
Well, I got the belt when I was little, and I'm okay. Like, I turned out okay. Let's just say
debatable,
but I'm pretty normal.
Definitely. Agree.
And I in particular, I have a three-year-old now who responds well to spanking. And what I mean by that is I really have not found another form of discipline that's worked as well as using a spoon.
So not timeouts, because I know timeouts is like the big, it's like the word, it's the thing.
Well, the timeouts, and I've tried, so we have it really set up. I'm not just randomly spanking whenever. So we have warnings, we have timeout, and then it's to a spank. And so I'm not instantly going to the spank, but I've tried every other way to not go to the spank, just because of all of the talk about how it could do this, and I've just heard so much.
Right. And so that's why you wouldn't instantly. So instead of just infraction, quick discipline, you would more...
I would prefer to, if a warning or a timeout is going to work, then fine, that's fine. But if I have to get to the point of spanking, that's okay with me too, because I've seen the fruit of it. And so, you know, I was talking to my husband this morning about it, and we were talking about how we've chosen to use a spoon rather than the hand when we go to spank.
Right.
And we were just talking about how the hand to us represents love, caring, nurturing, the parent role on that aspect. But if we can grab a spoon, and then the child's not instantly scared of you because you're raising your hand, we find that a lot more effective.
Right.
And you can't always have a spoon in arm's length, but I actually carry one in my car now. Because
smart mommy.
You know.
Especially when
you told me to do that.
I did, and it worked a treat.
Yes.
It worked a treat, that's for sure.
See, when I hear that, and I'm actually pro spanking as well, which is interesting because I grew up with zero boundaries. I literally ran the house. It was a sad story. My mom is much stronger now than she was back then.
Sure. You ran the house?
What does that mean?
No wonder you're such a...
Well, I mean, what I mean is I didn't have any boundaries. I didn't get disciplined, really.
Your parents didn't give you that.
Okay. Yes, and that's what I mean in that sense. But with the spanking, as an adult and a mother now, I actually feel that I don't want to use a spoon, because there was a few times when a family member in my household would hit with a brush, or there was times, because I was a very hyper kid, I would knock things over and I would get a jab with a fork. Things that were so far outside the spectrum what's healthy. Yeah. And not saying that a spoon, a wooden spoon, and a fork are the same. Right. What I am saying is, for me, I just saw other physical items get out of hand much more often than a hand.
So that was a reaction. So it wasn't loving discipline. No. It was like, you aggravated me. Right. I'm going to pick up the closest object and whack you with it.
And so growing up, having a conversation with my husband, I was like, are we going to spank? Are we not going to spank? I've seen it done so wrong. I've seen it done not at all. But we have actually felt that with the hand, I know how hard I'm hitting my daughter. Yes. And she's, you know, almost two now. And we have set up almost the same thing. She doesn't do timeouts yet. But where we have a comment saying, hey, like, do you understand what mommy said? Right. And if I feel that she understands me, then I'll say, okay, you get a smack. And we'll take her into the bathroom or into her room, somewhere that's not in front of our friends, not in front of a play date.
Humiliation.
But I just, when I hear about the spoons, and I love that y'all do it, I just get like, ooh, I'm just not a spoon fan.
Well, don't we have to talk about, like, the difference as well, like you brought up? There's discipline, which is actually care and love.
Absolutely.
To discipline is to care and to love.
Yes.
But then abuse is completely different.
So
when you, and it's really the person that's responsible and their action for it. So, you know, you're the holder of the spoon or what's in your hand.
Right. Yeah.
So you have to really assess yourself. And I know, you know, it's been heard, I know with my parents, they never spanked out of anger.
Right.
So they made a decision that, you know, if they saw something is wrong and needed to be disciplined, that they would do that. Now, what they always did with me was that, and then education.
Absolutely.
So it wasn't just, okay, they made sure that they weren't doing this out of anger, that this was really like, we need to discipline this child. Yeah. And they would do that. And then afterwards, I always remember, I didn't much care about the spanking. I was like, oh, they're going to talk to me forever. And I have parents that are pastors, so they had a lot of messages to practice on me.
Yes.
And so I'd be like, oh, okay.
Yeah.
And so, but they would always,
not being reactive.
Yeah, looking back now, I thank them for the education that was involved there too.
But you're right about the fact that that correction is actually love. Right. And I think that's what we think. Well, I love them, so I won't spank them. I won't.
Right.
I don't want to hurt them.
Right.
And there is a lot of people that have strong emotion around the using of any, what they would consider physical force when it comes to correction.
Yeah.
The Bible says, spare the rod, spoil the child. Right. So the Bible's actually clear, kind of like use a spoon, use a rod. And then it also talks about the fact that those who do not correct their son or their daughter actually hates them. And that's the vernacular that the Bible uses. Yeah.
I think there's been such a pendulum swing, because I know, and I don't know if this is an Australian thing, but I know when I went to school, it was actually okay for teachers to give you something called the cane, like smack you.
True.
Yeah. I don't know if that's a thing yet. But I remember it going horribly wrong in fifth grade. We used to get the ruler on our hand, and he got distracted and hit this kid here on their wrist, and it broke the capillaries in their hand. It was, that definitely went from being discipline to abuse. So I wonder if, like me, maybe their childhood had some negative approaches.
Then we got
2018, where there's now this whole movement, a political movement, to actually police whether you can smack or not smack your child. I know for, like, me and my husband, he gets quite, like, we do not discipline in public, because if someone misreads what you're doing, it could expose us for it seeming like abuse instead of discipline. So it's really, there's a hyper awareness right now around this. Is it actually discipline and love, or is it, are you opening the door to abuse? And you can't tell someone's healthy or not generally at the time.
Totally.
So is it something we do need to police as a state? It's an interesting question.
Well, I think it's good to be part of a healthy community at that point and put yourself around people who have been there, done that, and had some successful fruit to say, teach me how you raise your children.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You know, looking and seeing, a friend of mine actually told me about a study from Growing Kids God's Way. She told me that when you have alignment as a couple, a husband and wife, healthy, everything's okay with mum and dad, and you're breeding a healthy home, more than likely your kids are not going to act out as much. Mm. So when we're talking about discipline and spanking, if we take it back a couple of steps, what is the prevention from having bratty kids that are always throwing tantrums? And I would say, take a reading of what the culture and the atmosphere is in your home.
Beautiful.
Are mum and dad getting along? Mm-hmm. Like, are they sometimes acting out because they're frustrated? And for many toddlers, they don't know how to communicate outside of, I'm going to throw myself on the ground and kick and scream because I'm frustrated and I don't know why.
Yeah.
And then you're like, feel like you want to beat them within an inch of their life. Not literally.
Thank you.
But the solution oftentimes isn't spanking. It's like, man, we got to get our collective ish together in this household.
That.
And mum and dad need to get along.
Yeah. So I don't know if any of you guys have this. I have a couple of friends that are very anti-spanking, which is interesting to me. On your point, like, because it's our job as parents not to just always protect, but we've got to prepare our kids for the world that they're going to be in.
Yes.
And it's a physical thing of what happens to kids as they go into life. They're going to come up against all sorts of disciplines in life. And it's so important. And I've heard it said, if you can spank your kid up till like they're 5 years old, generally then you've got control of the behavior.
Yes,
so it's actually
true.
Really important when they're younger. We are preparing them for life. That's a huge stewardship as a parent.
I think it's important too that, you know, this is especially done, I would say, with the firstborn. Because I was second in line. I have two brothers that followed me. And I would say all of us got spanked a whole lot less.
Yes.
Sorry, sister. Yes. I love you.
My eldest child. Seriously.
But I'm going to say that the first child, but I think because it was... she was disciplined well, we all took notice. Like, I don't want that to happen, so I'm going to take notice
Lesson
of that.
Lesson learned.
So, you know, I think we have to look
we'll
at
pray
that
for the
kid.
Firstborns after.
I think with that as well, Stace, is that, and thinking back to my own life, the reason why I feel like I went so wild was because there was not consistency.
Right.
You
know?
And so I think you said it beautifully, is it's consistent. Your parents are consistent from kid one to kid however many in your family.
Four.
And I think that's absolutely the way to go. And I think also what Michaela said is bringing in, what are the steps I can take to set me up to have the conversations with my baby or my kid or my toddler that make it receivable and fruitful.
So they can understand.
Yes. And not like it's just
because. And don't you think also, too, just having the follow through.
Yes.
We always see those parents who threaten, and their kids are nightmares. And I'm telling you, it will actually stop you from being invited to people's houses. And really put a stigma around your family.
Wow.
If you've got unruly kids, you will stop getting invited to barbecues.
Yep.
They won't be coming to the kids' parties. They'll be avoiding you after church in case there is a mutual, you know, invitation to go somewhere. So I think it's just so vitally important that not only do we threaten, but we also follow through.
Yeah.
Right. That we say, if you do that again, behavior X again, you're getting a paddle. And then we do it when they do
it
again.
I so agree. And I think too, you know, speaking to the point of like, when does the police get involved? Should police? I think there should be an awareness. Absolutely. Because abuse is really real.
Yes.
And that needs to be, you know, be taken care
Most
of.
Definitely.
But I think that, you know, we don't only
put it in the hands Amen. Of, mm-hmm. you know, government or police. We have mm-hmm. to take responsibility as family members and as a community
yes.
to be helping in this, to see the fruit.
Yeah.
And just like you said, the health of children.
Yeah.
And so that's the result.
And some people don't know any better. And I know in the nation of New Zealand, it's now illegal to spank your children.
Wow.
And that decision was made because of the abuse
right.
in some of the more indigenous people
yeah. Yeah.
in that nation. So instead of bringing wise counsel, they
right.
said, you all are not even allowed to spank anymore.
Wow. Wow. It'll yeah. be interesting to see the fruit of that, because what's the
yeah.
other option? So the other option of discipline is really a timeout.
Right.
But if you think about it, like as the child grows up, gets older, faces reality, what are they going to do? Say, let me take a timeout?
Yeah,
like,
it's not realistic
yeah. when you grow up and you're an adult. You know,
need
living
a time
adult
out.
Life. Hold on, guys.
Well, it's happening.
In the colleges. Oops.
It's happening.
Yes.
Our safe spaces.
Yes.
They are literal
exactly.
timeouts where
you
get to pat a pony and
yes.
play with them.
Tell us how you really feel, Kayla.
I like this topic. I feel like
Thank
we could
you.
Talk about this again. I think we will. Thanks for joining us for another episode of Cherish TV. You have a great week, and we'll see you next time.